Hey everyone, so this video I am going to talk about observability pattern under microservices. So this topic, observability, comes into picture when we have sent all the services in production and all the services are serving live traffic, and I need to monitor the traffics that are coming, that are going through the services, and if any issue is coming, I should be able to properly debug and track the requests and response that are going through your services. So under observability, we are going to see different thing. First thing is about log aggregation. Second thing is distributed tracing, and then performance monitoring. And the most important thing we are going to see about health of the application. So let's go ahead and see one by one. We are going to analyze the significance and use cases and why do we need it properly. Let's start with the first one, that is log aggregation. Assume this is the online shopping portal that we have. We have product service, payment service, order, inventory service, and this is the client. And from here, or from order service, the request is starting, and then it is going to check the product service, and product service is going to check the status of the availability of the product in the inventory service. If all good, it is going to respond there. Product service is going to come here, and then order service is going to further call the payment service to process the payment. And doing all these things, each function that our services are doing, they are going to do log the function that they are doing. What do I mean by logging? They are going to record the things that they are doing. So for example, there is some method in product service. So what they are doing, that they are checking the product for the product ID, that is going to be logged in a log file in the application where they are deployed. So we are going to get a log file for each service, product service, payment service, and all other services that we have. They help us. Why do we log the things in services? Because in runtime, when there is any issue reported by the user, we need to debug that. So logs are our best friend to debug that issue, that what has happened with that one. So now coming to the, like, when any issue is reported by the user, I have to dig into the logs. So now the logs, if we have not used any tools, any strategy, so all the log files are going to be present with individual services that we have. So if the request is started from here, it is going here, and then it is coming here, then here. So I have to go to individual service services where they are deployed, and I have to search for the logs, right? This is the pain point, and this is the most impractical way, and we cannot do. And most obvious solution that we can have, we have to search in all the logs. Is there any way that I can pull out the log files that we have from all the services at one file here, and I can do all the searching and all the digging at one place where all the log files are aggregated at one place? This is what log aggregation means. Aggregation in itself means combining the things. Log means that log files that we have for each services. Now I hope you got the understanding what is this log aggregation about. Now the point is how we do it. So there are different third party tools. There are open source tools, there are paid tools as well that we can use, and we just have to configure that and they will start working. So let's see what are the available tools that we can use. First and foremost, and very popular, is Splunk, that we can use. Even I have been using in my company. This is very efficient. Other options that you can, this is the ELK that you can try and configure. This is also very popular. And Greylog is also there that you can use. We have one more, FluentD, that also gives good, that is also good tool for log aggregation. If you Google search about log aggregation tools, you will get many other tools as well, and you can use any of these. You just have to configure it and they will start working properly, right? So that's all about the log aggregation. Let's move to the next observability pattern topic that we have, is about distributed tracing. What do I mean by the distributed tracing? So as I was showing you, that this is the client here. For example, it has asked for the order status, for request has come to the order service, and then for the product status, it is going to call the product service. For the product availability, it is going to call the inventory service then. And if all fine, the response is coming back to order service, and it is going to check the finally payment status, that what was the status of the order. Right? This is the just dummy flow that I'm just trying to make, that the request is going to travel throughout the services that you have in production. Now, assume a scenario these are the different application deployed in and running in its own. And this request that is coming here R1, and it is coming here, and this R1 is coming here, and the same R1 is coming here as well, and it is coming back to order service, and same is coming here, and for the same response it is going to get. So you are seeing the trail, right? Same request is traveling throughout all the services, but without having any tools, any monitoring measures, we cannot trace that if this request is coming here, the same request is going here. It is going to generate lots of the logging, right? What function individual service is doing. But if I want to track that, I want to connect this request with this one when we are digging into the issue and debugging the things, that is difficult. What I am trying to say here, that when the request is being request is coming here under order service, you assign a particular ID. For example, I am giving it R1. Right, the moment it is, this order service is going to product service, keep this R1 as well, create one more ID that is going to track the sub function that this request is doing. Suppose I am saying it A1, then from product service it is going to this inventory service, I am saying it A2, because it is yet another jump that it is making from the application. From A2 it is going to this, from A2 it is just going to back to the order service, and then it is going to the payment service. And when it is going to payment service, I can say that it is A3. So A1, A2, A3 are showing the sub function that entire request is doing, and R1 is the complete flow of the request that it is having. So by combining R1 and A1, A2, A3, we can track the request from starting to end, and in the mid also what they are doing. This is the point about the distributed tracing, so that we can track the request throughout the system. In distributed system, tracking request and response is very important. Otherwise, it is going to be very difficult, impossible to get into the root cause of any issue. So how we can implement this distributed tracing? I hope you get the understanding and importance of the distributed tracing that it is going to play in the distributed system. So how many tools are there that we can use? So first, very popular, we have Zipkin that we can use. We have yet another tool, Jagger, that is yet another library that we can use and configure it. Open tracing also we have that we can use, and open census also we have. There are others as well, you can just Google it and you will find it. So I already have experimented about Zipkin, and I have created demo and all the theory about it. And Zipkin along with, we have Sleuth, which is provided by Spring Boot. So Spring Boot, Zipkin, Sleuth integration is very smooth and very easy to integrate with the microservices if you are creating that with Spring Boot and Java. So let me show you that playlist so that you can go ahead and check out that. For that, you just have to come to the channel here, and you just don't have to go anywhere. You come here and just search for your distributed tracing and hit enter. You will get this playlist here. View this playlist here, and here we have 5-6 videos here. You will get the complete understanding about distributed tracing and with Sleuth, and how we can integrate it with Zipkin. All the experiments are here, right? So you can go ahead and check out this one. That's all about distributed tracing. Let's move to the next topic that we have about performance of the application. I'm taking the same example here. Request is coming here, order service, it is going to product service, then it is coming to inventory service, and then we are performing the payment here. So when order service is going to product service, how much time it is taking to do the job of the product service? When the request is coming to inventory service, how much time it took to process that request? And payment service, how much time each service is taking to process the request? So by measuring the performance, we can come up with the plan to improve the things, and we can see the bottlenecks, and we can see the things, the methods, the code of lines that are taking too much time, and we can work on that to improve that. So performance measuring is all about measuring the times that it is taking to perform a particular action, and that depends all the time on the time, network connection, code, what data we are getting, and how much processing time that it is taking, right? So that's all about the performance. It's all about measuring the latency and timing that individual service is taking. So there are different tools available that we can use to monitor the performance of the application. First one in that we have Uptrends and we have .com monitor as well. We have Dynatrace. Dynatrace we are using in our company. It's very efficient and very effective tool, and it's fantastic to use. You can go ahead and try it. Other than that, we have Datadog as well, so you can try it as well. So all other there are many more as well. You can Google it and find more about it. So that's all about the measuring the performance of the application that we have. Coming to the next one, that is about the health check. So these are the individual services that are in production. How we are going to monitor the health of these ones? What do I mean by monitoring the health? Means they are up or not. Is there any reason that they are, if they are down, how we are going to know that? So we have to implement mechanisms in each service to check the health status. If you are using Spring Boot to create the microservices, there is concept of actuators that you can implement it to check the health of. You will get different endpoints. Health is one of that. You can get the information and others as well to monitor the health of the application in real time. So Spring Boot actuator, I already have created the demo. These two are the videos that you can go ahead and check out that. Let me show you this on the channel as well. So I was here, just go back here and coming to search tab here and actuator, and you will get these two videos here. First one, this custom actuator endpoint and Spring Boot actuator. First go to this 6.1 and then 6.2. You will get all the understanding about the Spring Boot actuator and how to use it. So that's all about the observability patterns. So coming to the big picture here that we are seeing here, so we have covered decomposition, database patterns, communication, integration patterns, and now this part is also done. We have seen log aggregation, performance metrics, distributed tracing, and health check. Somehow all of these are related. So this is very important. So I hope you got the theoretical understanding about it, and I have created some of the demo about it, like distributed tracing, health check. You go ahead and check out it. All other demos I'm going to create in the future videos. So what next I'm going to cover? So we have this cross-cutting concept, very important when you're developing individual microservices. So under cross-cutting concerns, first of all, I'm going to explain you about the circuit breaker pattern. So next that is coming up, it is about circuit breaker. Want to see all other topics under microservices architecture? This is the direct link that you can go ahead and check out. That's all about this video. I'm going to repeat the last line of the video, which is most obvious. If you found the content useful, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe the channel, and press the bell icon so that we get notification about every upload on the channel. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.